A reporter with the Associated Press nearly plunged us into World War III by getting some basic facts of a story completely wrong. Well, you know, 3 weeks ago, we did a story, and we talked about how so many experts that really do understand how the nuclear process works are saying we're edging more and more towards a nuclear disaster because of crazy steps that government's taken and the media's taken. This story's right on point, isn't it?
It is. You had this Associated Press reporter who immediately came out following an incident and said, oh my God, Russian missiles have been fired at Poland. Mm-hmm. They hit in Poland, they killed people. Russia is now attacking a sovereign NATO country. And the NATO country part of that is obviously the big deal, because if you attack a NATO partner, the rest of NATO is going to come at you. And he immediately reported that story. He said it was based on intelligence. I can't name the person.
Yeah, anonymous
somebody told me who's in the intelligence community this was Russia. And the entire media at that point was gearing up for World War III. That was all the headlines. That was all that was going on social media. We were on the cusp. We truly were.
Okay. You know, first of all, let me back up and break this down a little bit. Poland, the folks in charge of Poland said, no, it wasn't Russia. Right. There's a lot of bad stuff the Russians have done. I mean, you want to talk about some really, really bad stuff, there's plenty to talk about. But not to the point to where some little freak says, I have to be the first to get the story.
Yep.
You know, I was a journalism major back at University of Florida, and back then it used to be important that you could verify a story, that there was no race to get the first printout when it's something as serious as potential world war. And, you know, when we did that segment last time, I remember, I don't know who these commenters are that came in on the to comment on the segment, but it's an overstatement of the risk. You don't worry about nuclear war. Nonsense. This is how it happens. And so this cat, they fire him, but you know what? It ought to wash up his career, tell you the truth. The severity of what happened here was so serious that they not only fired him, but, you know, I think he's going to have a tough time getting a job.
Oh,
Due diligence, isn't that still important?
It really is, but you nailed it on the head. That's how the media works these days. It doesn't matter how accurate your story is. What matters is how quickly you get it out there. You'll issue the retractions and the corrections later on, but you have to be the first to put it out there, because the media is no longer about spreading information. It's a business.
It's a race.
It's about making money.
And war is a big money maker.
It is.
You know, we talk about, if you take a look at MSNBC right now, or Fox, or CNN, God bless CNN, if they're around for another year. But the point is, if you take a look at who they're pushing retired generals. This is retired General Jones. Well, they don't tell the backstory. Retired General Jones is working for friggin' Raytheon right now, okay? Smith is working for Boeing. They have a direct interest in going on the air and scaring the hell out of everybody about what's happening in the Ukraine. Well, they should go on the air, and they should talk about the balance, the slim balance that's taking place right there. You could be involved in a nuclear conflict that quick. Putin is a crazy man. He is a lunatic. And this story, to me, I mean, going forward, these folks need to be really, really careful. This is corporate media mentality. How do we get advertisers? Well, we create a big story. Nuclear war is a pretty damn big story that they're about to create if they're not careful.
And it's very disturbing, too, to see this from the Associated Press.
Oh, I know.
I mean, you know, you could understand if it's one of the corporate media outlet or cable news outlets doing this. Yeah. Associated Press, you're held to the highest of the high standards.
Right.
And when y'all get something so badly wrong
it bleeds everywhere, doesn't it?
It does.
This story was around for 3 days before anybody knew it was nonsense.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe 4 days.
I don't think most people understand that those missiles actually came from Ukraine. It was an accident.
Yeah, of course.
But that's where the missiles came from.
But the easy story is to sell the jazz, right? And
yep.
The jazz is Russians do it again. They want to start a nuclear war. They're bombing Poland. Jesus Christ.